Welcome students. Now another lecture purely with the word problems, and really you will enjoy this lecture. This is the most important lecture, today's lecture and the lecture after this, because it will be dealing purely with the word problems, all of you. Okay, the very first thing is to understand the story given in the question. So with the green pen I'll be explaining you all. Mrs. Kapoor has a negative balance of ₹1,500 in her bank account at the start of June. Oh, so sad. Mrs. Kapoor has a negative balance of ₹1,500 in her bank account at the start of June. Okay, so let's say that at the start of June, at the start of June, Mrs. Kapoor goes to the bank, her bank, and she asks for the balance. And they says, "Madam, you have a negative balance. You have a negative balance means -1,500 in your bank account at the start of June." Okay, at the beginning of June, the total balance, the amount in her bank account is what? -1,500. Pay attention. After she deposited ₹450 for 3 months, what is her new balance? Then she was very shocked. Oh my God, I have a negative balance. That means I'm not saving any money. So what she did? She cultivated the habit of saving. After she deposited rupees 450 for 3 months. Okay, for 3 months. For 3 months it's given to us. So now let's say here we have June. So now I can say July. It's not given in the question, but just 3 months. Just to make you all understand, I'm writing this. July, August and September. Each month she deposited in the bank how much? ₹450. So she deposited, so +450. Why +450? Because she is saving, she is putting this amount in the bank. +450 because she is depositing. +450. Okay, so this is the case, all of you. So this is the story. Now what is her new balance? So at the end of September, we can say at end of September, what will be the total balance in her bank account? Earlier at the start of June, it was -1,500. Then in July, August, September, in the next 3 months, see, she deposited to 450 each month. Okay. So now what will be the balance in her account? It is so simple, student, very simple. Okay, how to start with the solution? Whatever I explained you over here, it was just a note for you all, just for the explanation. Definitely you can write it, or you should write it in your notebook, but in exam you don't need to write this. It was just for the explanation, please, all of you. Okay, pay attention here, all of you. I'm starting with the solution. So Mrs. Kapoor has a negative balance of ₹1,500 in her bank account at the start of June. So in the solution part, I'll write balance. In the beginning, I'll say balance at the start of June. Balance at the start of June. I'm using the same words which is given in here. Is equal to -1,500. Here negative word is mentioned. -1,500. Okay. Then afterwards she deposited ₹450 for 3 months. Okay. So I'll say amount deposited in next three months will be how much? See all of you, after she deposited ₹450 for 3 months, matlab in Hindi har mahine, every month she is putting 450. So 3 multiply by 450, all of you. Okay, 3 5s is 15, carry 1. 3 4s are 12 plus 1, 13, and this 0 comes down and it's ₹1,350. So that means the total amount deposited in 3 months is ₹1,350. Now please pay attention, all of you, what's asked over here. What is her new balance? New balance means at the end of these 3 months, what is the total amount of money in the bank? Okay, so now I'll write here. Therefore, new balance, or in the bracket I'll write total amount of money इन हर बैंक अकाउंट, इन हर बैंक अकाउंट, अकाउंट वी कैन राइट इन शॉर्ट फॉर्म लाइक दिस, A/C अकाउंट, आफ्टर 3 months इज इक्वल टू, इट्स वेरी ऑब्वियस, अर्लियर इट वॉज बिफोर दीज 3 months, इन जून, एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ जून इट वॉज -1,500 ऑफकोर्स रुपीज, सिंबल विल कम रुपीज -1,500, एंड एट द एंड ऑफ दीज 3 months आफ्टर जून शी पेड टोटल 1,350. सो वॉट इज द नेट अमाउंट इन हर बैंक, और वॉट इज द टोटल बैलेंस, न्यू बैलेंस इन हर अकाउंट. सो इट विल बी, earlier it was what, it was -1,500 and then +1,350. So in the rough work I'll do it over here, plus minus will be minus only, plus minus will be minus, sign of greater number, of course 1,500 is greater, so still the amount remains in minus only. Okay, so plus minus minus 1,500 and 1,350, please all of you, so it will be 150 rupees, so -150 rupees symbol, don't forget this rupees symbols, if you don't put this rupees symbol your one mark will be deducted. So still her account is in negative, and it's compulsory to write the final statement, it's compulsory. So her new balance, all of you, therefore her new balance is equal to rupees -150, all of you. Okay, pause the video please. It was a very amazing question. I was just explaining it, that's the reason it took so long. This thing in the green color is just a note for you all. It's fine, it's good if you write it, but in exam no need to write it, all of you. Just 5 lines the question is. Leave lines between every step, please. Pause the video, please. And next question, students, it's very, very simple. Very, very simple question. But if you read the story, this question, you will feel that it is very complicated. Because they portray like this just to confuse you. That's the reason students get scared with the word problems. It's the most easiest question, I will say, of the textbook. The origin of a spring is 12 feet below the ground level. There is a spring. The origin means the starting point. Origin means the starting. The starting point of the spring, of a spring, is 12 feet below the ground level. Okay, let us assume something over here. Let me explain you all with the help of a diagram. Let us say this is my ground level. This black line is my ground level. This is my ground level. Okay, and I have a spring here. The origin of a spring is 12 feet below the ground level. Okay, let us say that I have a spring here. Okay, and this is the origin, the starting point. Okay, this is the origin. The word origin is used over here in the question, or in other words, starting point. Starting point of the spring. Okay, the origin or the starting point of the spring is here, over here. Okay, so the origin of a spring is 12 feet below the ground level. Okay, it's 12 feet below the ground level. So this origin and this ground level is how much? It's 12 feet. It's 12 feet. Okay, so the distance between the ground level and the origin of the spring is how much? 12 feet, please, all of you. Okay, if a machine can dig, okay, I have a machine with me, can dig 3 feet at a time. A machine can dig a 3 feet at a time. See, if I take a machine, I start digging it. Then at a time, at a single trial of the machine, ek time pe Hindi mein, machine can dig only 3 feet. Only 3 feet. Then how many times would the machine have to be used to reach the origin of the spring? If one time if I use the machine, it can dig only 3 feet. FT means feet. Second time, if I use the machine, it will once again dig only more 3 feet. Third time, if I dig the machine, it will dig more 3 feet, like this. Okay, so first time if I use the machine, it will dig 3 feet. Then I will be reaching over here. Then I will be on this mark. Then second time, if I use the machine, then it will dig more 3 feet. Then I will reach over here. Third time, if I use the machine, then it will dig more 3 feet. Third time, so I'll be reaching here. So first time if I use the machine, I'm 3 feet down. Then second time if I use the machine, I'm 6 feet down. Third time I use the machine, I'm 6 plus 3, 9 feeds down. So it will go on and on and on and on and on and on. Until unless we reach the origin. And origin is how much? Origin of the machine is 12 feet. Okay, so 3 feet. If I dig one time, I'm 3 feet down. Second time, I reach 6 feet down. Third time, I reach 9 feet down. Fourth time, if I dig, once again, I'll be digging up how much? 3 feet. And 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. And 9 plus 3, 12. So I'll be reaching it over here at the origin. Understanding? First time I dig, I'll be 3 feet down. Second time if I dig, I'll be 6 feet down. Here it's 3 feet. Afterwards, when I reach here, I'm 6 feet down. Because second time also machine digged 3 feet. Then after this, third time when machine digged, I'm 3 feet more down. So I'll be reaching it by 9 feet below the ground level. Once more, if I call out the machine, then it will dig more 3 feet. And then I will reach, and the fourth time, I'll be reaching here over 12 feet down, all of you. Understanding? So 4 times I need to use the machine. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. And 9 plus 3, 12. And after the fourth time I use the machine, I'll be straight away to the origin, please. I'll be straight away to the origin, all of you. Understanding? So basically, it's so simple. It's so simple. They have given to us that one time mein machine can dig only 3 feet. And there are 12 feet. 12 feet distance we have. So just the answer is what? 12 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3, 4s are 12. So 4 times I have to use the machine. It's so simple. But when you read the question, you feel that it's very difficult question. In other words, I can just portray this question as I have, for example, 12 rupees in my hands. In my hand. I have 12 rupees in my hand. And cost of one chocolate. And cost of one chocolate is rupees 3. Cost of one chocolate is rupees 3. Say, how many chocolates will I get? It will be 12 divided by 3. And answer is 4. I'll get 4 chocolates. Similarly, I have to reach 12 feet down at the origin of the spring. Ek time mein, in one shot, machine can dig only 3 feet. So how many times I need to use the machine? One time I'll reach 3 feet. Second time I'll reach 6 feet. Third time I'll reach 9 feet. And fourth time I'll reach 12 feet. So how to calculate it? We just have to divide. It's a single line answer. 12 divided by 3. Answer is 4. Everything what I explained, you please write it. Please write it in your notebook. Whatever I explained it over here, this everything over here on the right hand side is note for you all. You don't have to write this in the answer, in the examination. This diagram is just for your reference. Draw it right now, but we will not do it in the examination. Okay, let's start with the solution over here. It's very simple, all of you. Origin of spring is 12 feet below ground level, the first point over here. Okay, now we know that if a machine can dig 3 feet at a time, okay, so therefore, how many times would the machine be required? Therefore, number of times machine required will be 12 upon 3. 3 ones are 3, 4s are. So 4 is our answer. Therefore, the final statement, therefore, number of times machine required to reach, the final answer should be in the statement form in all the word problems, to reach the origin of the spring is equal to 4. 4 times the machine is required, all of you. Pause the video, please. It was so simple question. Pause the video, please, and do it fast. Okay, students, now the next question with green color. Yes, it's an amazing question. Pay attention. On a rainy day, okay, we all love rains, right? On a rainy day, the amount of rain in a rain gauge increased by 4 inches over a 24-hour period. Okay, full stop. Understand, please, this sentence. Understand the story, all of you. On a rainy day, the amount of rain in a rain gauge increased by how much? 4 inches over a 24-hour period. So can I say in my terms, in my language, in 24 hours, how much rain got increased? it increased by 4 inches. The rain in the rain gauge increased by 4 inches in how much hours? 24 hours. Okay, so let me write it quickly. Hope you all understood. Once again, amount of rain in a rain gauge increased by 4 inches over a 24 hour period. 20 in 24 hour span, in 24 hour span, the amount of rain increased in the rain gauge is how much? 4 inches. 24 hours mein, it got increased by 4 inches. Let me very quickly write it down first. I'll write here very quickly in the solution. In 24 hours, in 24 hours, increase in rain is equal to 4 inches, is equal to 4 inches. Okay, next, let's read the next sentence, all of you. All eyes over here, please. How much, pay attention, please, all of you over here. How much will the amount of rain in the gorge will increase by over a 9-day period? Now, all eyes over here, all eyes over here. What they are asking us, they are asking us that how much rain will increase in the period of 9 day, 9 days period, in 9 days period, all of you. Arre, what data they have given to us? They have given to us that rain gets increased by 4 inches in 24 hours. Data what they have given to us is in hours. 24 hours mein the amount of rain which gets increased is by 4 inches. But now they are asking us, they are expecting us to give the amount of rain increased in the rain gauge in after 9 days. After 9 days. So first of all, the given data is insufficient for us, because whatever things are given to us is in the form of hours. First, we have to convert it into days. Then only, because our expectation, the requirement in the question is in days. So can I say 24 hours? All of you pay attention. 24 hours means 1 day. So can I say in 1 day? In 1 day, just I'll write this exactly same, but only change what I did is 24 hours means 1 day. So in 1 day, then I'll copy this and exactly same. This exactly same I'll copy. In 1 day, increase in rain. Increase in rain is equal to 4 inches. This was the catch of the question, please, all of you. I converted the 24 hours in 1 day, in the number of days. So in 1 day, now it's so simple, all of you. In one day, how much inches? There was an increase in how many inches? In 4 inches of rains. Now what is asked over here? How much will be the amount of rain in the gorge will increase in 9 days? Therefore, in nine days, increase in rain is equal to question mark. We don't know. It's so simple. 1 day mein it got increased by 4 inches. So 9 days mein kitna increase hoga? Question mark. I don't know. I'll call it as X. Is it very clear? Is it so simple? Yes. Now how to solve it? We'll solve it by traditional method. Please here, all of you see over here. You will not draw this line because I don't have space. That's why I'm drawing it. See here. First, I'll write here number of days. Number of days. You all will make this table. You all will make this number of days. And here I'll write, this is the best and easy method. You can solve by your method also. Number of days. And here, increase in rain. Increase in rain. Number of days, increase in rain. In bracket, I'll write in inches. We are measuring it in inches. So in one day, what was the increase in the rain? Rain got increased by 4 inches in the rain gauge. So by 4 inches. No need to write this inches because I already wrote here, but I'm writing it for understanding. In 1 day, it got increased by 4 inches. And they are asking us how much, you see here, how much the amount of rain in the rain gauge will be increased over the span of 9 days. So in 9 days, increase in rain will be how much? X. So in nine days, it will be increasing by X inches. Isn't it very simple, all of you? Now we just have to cross multiply. X gets multiplied with 1 and 9 gets multiplied with 4. Therefore, X, after this you will be continuing over here. You will not do like this horizontally. I don't have place vertically, so that's why I'm doing it like this. X multiplied by 1 is equal to 4 multiplied by 9. X one is X only. Therefore, X is equal to 9, 4 is 36. 36 inches, all of you. So, final statement is compulsory, all of you, in the word. So, how much will the amount of rain in the rain gauge increase over a 9 days period? Therefore, 36 inches will be increase, will be the increment in rain, in the rain gauge after 9 days. All of you, wasn't it very simple? Pause the video please and do it fast.